Welcome. You're watching the Thrift Store Rundown celebrating Labor Day weekend by doing what we do best, bringing Hollywood home on a budget. As I said earlier, we're doing a series of Labor Day reviews centered around activities that you and the fam would probably like to enjoy during this most treasured of leisurely holidays. The next of those being going to the beach. If you're not fixing to go to the beach this year because you can't afford it, among other sad reasons, well, why not bring a bit of the beach home? And while you're at it, why not bring home a pet monkey to really shake things up? Speaking of which, that's exactly one of the moves you'll have to pull off to win the Curious George Discovery Beach game from WonderForge. It is an I Can't Do That game for any amount of players ages 3 and up. It's an I Can't Do That game, meaning that it's so simple for kids to play. Plus, it's actually more compact than you might think because all the treasures in here and the sand, quote-unquote, stay sealed inside this shaken-look box, which is the foundation of this entire game. And aside from that, we have 5 puzzle piece stores, 21 treasure pieces, 1 spinner and game rules manual, 29 cards, and 140 grams, that's 4.94 ounces, of sand. This was picked up for $2.99 and for 75% off. The reason why you don't see a price tag on the box is because it was on some packaging tape that I had to take off. It was securing the box. Miraculously, no damage was done to the box art. Wherever this was sold beforehand, it was priced at $19.95. You can hear that? So we have the spinner, we have the game rules manual, we have the cards, and again, everything's contained inside this shaken look box. And you see why these are not really meant to be called doors? Because if they were, they would stay inside the box, inside their spaces, with a little flap still attached to the box, so that you can turn these doors open and closed, open and closed, open and closed, like this puzzle piece door in the shape of a boot. As always, we give you 10 seconds to look at the instruction manual here. Control room, 10 seconds. There you go. To summarize gameplay for you, the object of this game is to collect 6 cards. So, spin the spinner. You can look under any one of these spaces here, which would, coincidentally, match up to all 5 puzzle pieces. Any other space other than the wave, you would have to choose between one of these 2 spaces. You can't choose both. So for example, if you were looking for a shark, let's see here, I would choose the sailboat space. And there'd be no shark in there. Oh well. Play will continue until somebody actually finds what they're supposed to be looking for on the back of one of these cards here. However, if you spin the spinner and it lands on the wave space, whatever, just trying to make a point. Then you gotta shake the box side to side. Don't shake it up or down or else the puzzle pieces fall. Shake it side to side, and then spin again. Play will continue until you find 6 cards. It doesn't matter if they're one of each that the cards indicate here. It's a very simple game. No wonder it's branded as an I Can Do That game. Actually, before we close it up, let's just take a look at the back here. Here it is with the puzzle pieces falling down. There you go. Join Curious George on a seesaw scavenger hunt. Search for sea creatures and colorful treasures hidden below 5 secret beach locations. Find the most treasures to win. There are 21 hidden treasures in all. Flip a card for a new challenge. 5 secret locations. If you spin a wave, watch out. Shake the box. The treasures slide and hide in new locations. And while we have those puzzle pieces out, why don't we just shake this up side to side so you can see the sand and treasures move. And the sand, by the way, is actually tiny, tiny, tiny blue pellets in lieu of actual grains of sand. Which strikes me as odd because Have a look at the box. I can actually feel tiny, minuscule grains of sand that one would have to view through a microscope to actually see in this sneak peek space. The try me section, if you look. I gotta tell you, going to the beach is actually one of the most awesome ways to fuel a child's curiosity. I know it's one of my favorite ways because it's one of my favorite vacation destinations. And I've been to the beach many times before. I'm sorry to say that I didn't go this year because I really didn't think much of it. But, oh well. Enough of my personal problems. If you want to bring a bit of the beach home, this is a pretty good way to go about it. It's easy to assemble. It's easy to store. And it might conjure up some fond memories of your family vacations to the beach and all the different aquatic treasures and otherwise that you would find. So I'm giving this 5 out of 5 claps. This is actually the first Curious George review I've done in a long time and the second overall. It won't be the last. Next week, Curious George takes a vacation and discovers new things in this top flight hit. With 8 episodes on one DVD. That'll be next week. Because after all, curiosity might do some cats away, but it can never screw up a monkey, right? Okay, maybe it can, but really, if it didn't screw up this monkey to the point where he would go off on all sorts of wacky and educational and fun adventures, then he would never have enthralled generations of children. Hey, sometimes the best childhood treasures really are hidden. In plain sight.
It's only the ocean and you, and all of these lines will all be erased soon. They go out with the tide and come back with the waves. So it's only the ocean and you.
TSR. Now, to see another awesome review like this one, click here. If you want to become a Hollywood bargain hunter, click here to subscribe. And I'll catch you on the thrift side.